Careto, also known as the Mask, is a highly advanced threat actor. This AP2 group in particular is unusual for a number of reasons. One, they're highly focused at what they do. So the number of victims was fairly low, although it was a significant set of campaigns. They developed rootkits, that would steal everything from Wi-Fi communications to PGP keys or other ways of encrypting and hiding sensitive data. They targeted everything from government organizations to private equity to energy companies. They didn't work specifically within the Windows environment. So they were very aggressive about targeting not only Windows, but Apple systems and Linux, whatever they came across. So they were very agile in what they were doing, and they were also very professional in their operations. So they monitored what was going on about exposure of their operations, and they beat Red October, Flame, and every other actor we've seen in shutting down their infrastructure once they were exposed. So they were clearly aware of whether or not their operations were known and how they were handling it. Their encryption strategies were very interesting and very advanced. The group itself maintained both a development edge and an operational edge that we really haven't seen before. And then finally, one of the more significant and extraordinary things about Careto is that instead of trying to evade security defenses, they went after the defense itself. So they would attack older vulnerabilities in AV products or anti-malware products in order to get after the victim they were targeting. And they were very successful at it. That's something that we hadn't seen in previous APT, like Dooku or Flame, for example. Among the things that are pretty unique about Careto are the fact that they have not only a broad technology set that they can target and go after, but the target profiles of the victims included things like private equity firms, commercial organizations like Big Energy. They were not shy about who they were going after. It didn't need to be a governmental organization to be a victim of Careto, and it was a global issue. It wasn't limited to one geographical region or another. And then finally, these guys aren't going away. In all likelihood, when you take all the characteristics of the technology, the operations, the focus, the victim profiles, more likely than not, we believe that Careto was a nation-state backed operation. Meaning, when you're dealing with a determined adversary who wants to get in, they aren't going to go away. There aren't simple measures that take care of everything with Careto. You need to be able to understand, not only understand your adversary, but understand your own network and be able to best defend it in order to get these guys to go away.